This is the Thursday edition of TVC Breakfast. I am Kemi Foladiemo with Olamide Adeyemi.
Good morning, Kemi.
Good morning. Good to see you.
Well, it's good to be here once again after the little break.
I know. And how's the week been?
It's been great, really. But, you know, apart from the long queues at the filling stations, on my way here this morning, I could see some persons already at 4 a.m. At the front of the filling station. So the queues continue, and Nigerians, of course, are expecting, an option at this time, a better option at this time.
Absolutely. It's so hard not to miss those queues, especially at this time of the day when you happen to be, you know, either commuting or driving or as the case may be. And, you know, those thoughts also passed through my mind this morning, you know, seeing those queues, those endless queues, despite the fact that we have witnessed an increment in fuel prices, you know, but that still has not made this commodity as available as it should be. And that's how we start off this morning, because that appears to be, that is still the most prominent story or news development here in Nigeria. Lagos is grappling with a deepening fuel crisis. It's not only Lagos, and these development is marked by soaring prices and scarcity following the recent price hike. Now, well, from what we have seen, the Nigerian National Petroleum Company Limited, NNPCL, adjusted prices upward after admitting to owing suppliers $6.8 billion, leading to a nationwide surge in pump prices. And here in Lagos, the official base price is now 855 naira to a litre, while independent marketers are selling at higher prices, ranging from 900 to 1,200 naira per litre. The scarcity has created opportunities for black market dealers who are exploiting the crisis by charging up to 1,500 naira per litre. Motorists and commuters are also experiencing significant inconvenience with long queues and exorbitant costs. Traders are warned of an inevitable rise in the prices of goods and services due to the escalating transportation costs. The effects of this hike are rippling through the economy, affecting food prices, market prices, as well as overall living costs. The situation has disrupted daily routines, with commuters spending almost double on transport and traders struggling to cope with the price increase. The Trade Union Congress has also warned that the petrol price increase will worsen poverty among workers. The fuel crisis persists despite the arrival of petrol vessels at Lagos ports, highlighting the need for a sustainable solution to address the country's fuel challenges. And talking about these fuel challenges, of course, they are perennial, because we have never seemed to come out of this unwholesome crisis. Queues, you know, when I heard the news of, yet another increment in the fuel prices, I raged within myself, and I asked why it has to come to this. And, you know, when you now look at the margin that one will now have to deal with, of course, the first thought that would also come after the shock, the anger, and all of that would be the thought that, would we now get to have it available? Will the queues disappear? But as we started off the show with this morning, that is yet to be the case. Of course, the justification for that amount is also a question, because NNPC, that has been the sole importer all this while of this crude oil, had always, you know, expressed confidence in assuring the public that it had more than enough to serve, even though the statistics on the ground said otherwise. But now, for them to now admit to a humongous debt going to $6.8 billion, and, you know, a few days after that admission, we now have, we are left with this announcement that they will now have to increase the price of fuel, per litre, 855, depending on where you are. It could even be as high as 900.
Well, it's great that, you know, you addressed it from the two different sides, about the cost and also the availability of this this petrol, the fuel price and all that. So it's also very important for us to know that this has crippled businesses in the past few weeks, what we are going through. And before the NNPC came out themselves to admit this humongous debt, like you attributed it, one will also say that to an extent, they have most times said they are not actually owing. So many factors we'll consider at this time. So many persons will want to, you know, rely on the Dangote refinery like we have, you know, also seen in the past few days. But then there are also concerns about how soon that will be available. We also expect the Federal Executive Council to also agree on a price, which is part of what the market editor, the TVC market editor, also spoke about as to the reason and what will come out of what the Dangote refinery is doing in Nigeria especially, and what this also poses for our foreign exchange as to, you know, other nations and all that. You know, so at this point where the NNPC has, you know, acknowledged this debt that we are facing to an extent, we may have to wait for what the Federal Executive Council will decide as to the refinery's price. But for those who are saying that, because some persons have also mentioned that probably Dangote should be a patriot and should reduce the price of the petrol, so many persons have said a business is a business. And so as a businessman, of course, he will be putting in the cost of what the raw materials he used in this. So many factors to consider. But the queues have continued. So many persons are lamenting. The businesses also have to run. People have to also survive. On my way coming this morning, like I also mentioned, from the Alakpere area of Ketu, I could see some queues as long getting into Ogudu area. So it's really sad. It's really sad at this time. But we are hoping for a better option at this time. The Dangote refinery may be a better option, but it depends on what the price is going to see after the Federal Executive Council meeting decides.
Right. And, you know, talking about Dangote, he gave a maximum of 2 days before the commodity will now start to be released from his refinery. And if my arithmetic serves me well, today we should begin to, you know, have some, you know, positives in that direction. There should be availability of fuel now across the country, especially in Lagos. Lagos had always, you know, been enjoying a somewhat, you know, special status when it comes to fuel scarcity over the past episodes. But this one now is about 2 months old, if I'm correct. This particular episode of fuel scarcity, Lagos hasn't been having it easy at all. Just when you think it will ease out, then again you have it. And with this latest announcement, it is definitely bound to even more have more impact on Lagos residents as well as other residents across. And again, it's the weekend, or it's the week before schools resume. Lagos students will also be resuming as from Monday. So, you know, all those thoughts are reverberating right now. That's why, you know, many are urging the federal government to do more in engaging and communicating with critical stakeholders, not just government entities and the likes, but critical stakeholders to find a way out of the mess that we are in. But we'll put a hold on our conversation now. There's still so much more to discuss during the course of the program today. Let's bring you